Today we're unboxing this guy to go over a few reasons why this is one of the best generators. First, we got to get this guy out of the box and set up. And as you can see, it says no oil. And that's one thing with Honda is that they don't ship you anything extra except the manual and pretty much the generator. You don't get oil, a toolkit, or anything else fancy. It's just basically that manual and this generator, as you can see as you pull it out of the box. Well, that's pretty much it. So we're going to go ahead and get this guy set up, and if you're not familiar with Honda products, this is basically the same generator as their older 2000 model with a few upgrades to it. And so before we get fuel and oil added to it, we'll check the weight real quick because it's stated at 47.5 pounds, and you can see it comes out right at 48, and so with just a little room for error, that's pretty much good enough. So we got to get the oil in this thing first, and as you can see right here, if you don't have something to measure it, well, it basically just tells you to put the oil up towards the threads or go ahead and read that manual because it does have your registration card, cool accessories, and not to mention good information that you could read inside. Now that we got that out of the way, let's go ahead and get set up. And again, it doesn't give you any oil like some of the other companies do, but that's all right. We'll just go ahead and get our own. And one thing with Honda is they keep maintenance simple by being able to using like maybe a washer or a quarter, or you just go ahead and get your screwdriver to do the maintenance on this thing, which makes it really easy. So there we got exposure to our oil access plug. And we're going to look at the manual again to also take a look at what kind of weight oil we need. And it says 1030 is recommended. And again, you can see how much, but we're actually going to go with a 5-weight, 30-weight. That way it gives us a broader range of protection. So we'll go ahead and measure out 14 ounces is what we kind of need. So we'll go ahead and take out that dipstick and take a look. And you want to look on there just to see if there is any oil left, because some generators will actually have some oil left in it and you may not need all of the 14 ounces. So we'll go ahead and place a rag and we'll start to pour the oil in. And again, only do about half of this. That way you can check the oil level just to see where it's at, because you don't want to overflow it and spill it. And now that we've got the correct amount of oil there, as you can see on the threads, we'll go ahead and put that oil plug back in. Then we'll go ahead and move along to the next step. But remember to also check in for your break-in hours, because you'll want to change this oil within about an hour or two after break-in. And it's also not a bad idea to familiarize yourself with the engine, like checking out the manual choke lever here, or also the air filter box, which also uses the same screw, which again makes maintenance really easy. So we'll go ahead and get this side panel back on, and then we'll go over a few of the other features of this generator. But first, we'll remove that tag. So you see the Cominder on the generator, that's actually a carbon monoxide detector and will shut the generator down if the levels are too high. Plus your indicator lights, which that green one acts as an hour meter, a Bluetooth, which will set that up in a little bit. And then right next to that, you can see the eco throttle switch along with your parallel ports. And then you can see on this 15 amp rated generator, this one just comes with the 110 outlet plugs. And just by looking at these, they're actually pretty good quality, much better than some of the other ones that I have seen. Another item that they did add was a fuel shutoff switch. With most all the new generators, this is pretty standard, just like on the Honda. So when you actually run this generator and you put it into that position, it'll drain the fuel out of the carburetor, making it excellent for long-term storage. So we'll go ahead and fuel up the generator. And just another thing for a side note, while you guys are doing this, it's not a bad idea to add some kind of a fuel treatment or fuel conditioner. I happen to like Lucas products. I've been using it for a long time with good luck, so I'm not sponsored by them. It's just a product that I happen to like. And now that we got the fuel in this guy, we'll go ahead and close the cap and open that vent. Then we'll turn the fuel selector switch to on. We'll go ahead and open that choke all the way. So now with about 4 pulls, this guy fired up to life. And so now we can get this guy running. We'll do some testing on it here in just a minute after we put that choke off. And so now you can see this guy is running and it sounds great. So we're going to go ahead and turn on that eco throttle switch to kind of quiet it down. And it's actually not a bad idea while we're here. We'll go ahead and get our Bluetooth set up on our phone so we can kind of see what's going on. So you'll have to go to the app store and get the Honda My Generator app. And then you'll go through the setup process. And then after you've done all of that, go ahead and go to the home screen. And that'll show you a whole bunch of cool information. So now when you put a load on your generator, such as like this heat gun, we'll just turn it on low. And so now you can see it brings it up to about 770 watts or so. And it shows you how long your oil life is, along with how many engine hours are on it. And I've only got about 30 minutes on this generator so far. So we'll go ahead and shut it off. And as you can see there, it tells you to just basically press and hold that stop button for 1.5 seconds. So we'll go ahead and do that. Now the generator basically shuts down, and before you close the app, it'll give you a couple of tips. So we'll go ahead and start off with our sound check as our first test, and we're going to do this at about 23 feet away. And we're going to actually compare it with the old Honda, because the new Honda has a bigger engine. And so we'll see if it's a little bit louder with 121 cc's versus 98.5 cc's. And you can find out all kinds of specs like that from Generator Bible. If you guys haven't been here before, click up in your search bar and put in Generator Bible, and then go ahead and click on the link where you'll find over over 500 generators that you guys can compare and choose from, including all the best sellers, not to mention new products, or if you know by brand, there's 26 to choose from. Not to mention they have generator sizing tools along with filters that help you narrow down your search. And once you've found a generator that you're looking for, go ahead and click on it where they'll give you more information, including pricing tools. Not to mention if you also want to compare a couple generators side by side, you can do that as well, which will help you find all the differences and then educate you on buying the correct generator. So make sure to check out Generator Bible. So we're going to go ahead and start off our sound check now, and we're going to start with a new Honda generator, and we basically have it in the eco mode. It's 23 feet away, and if you guys had this out camping where there's some bushes, rocks, dirt, it's actually going to be even quieter than it would be just sitting on concrete. But even at 57.3 decibels roughly on average, it's still pretty darn quiet. So we're going to go ahead and go back down there, turn the eco mode off, then we'll let it rev up a little bit. This will kind of simulate a load. So now that the generator is revved up a little bit higher, these are kind of the normal numbers I was seeing from the other generator, but we'll pull that one up here in just a second. As you can see, after letting it run for a little bit, about 62 decibels, so pretty good. So we're going to go ahead and get the other generator up here, and we'll do the exact same test. So now you can see the old generator is out there running, but you can probably hear it is kind of hesitating a little bit. And this was a common problem on these older 2000 ones, where basically the emission stuff has these running so lean that sometimes they would basically kind of hunt for RPM with no load on it. But once you put a load on, it's fine. But even then, you can see the decibel levels look pretty much identical. And so now that we have the eco off on the old generator, I'm starting to get a couple spikes here and there, but for the most part, if you kind of look at it, the decibel levels are actually the same, running at about 62 to 63. So for the most part, the old Honda generator and the new Honda generator pretty much sound the same, even though the new Honda generator does have a bigger engine. So we're going to go ahead and test out that CoMinder real quick. And so I have this in the bed of my truck. We're going to go ahead and fire it up. I'm going to have the eco mode off so the RPMs are high. And then we're going to set a timer and just kind of see, well, how long does it take for this thing to shut off and how well it works. So there you can see I got the timer going. I'll speed up the video. And it is a little hard to hear, but literally after about 25 seconds, it's already shut off. And I did stop the timer a little bit late. But as you can see here by the generator, the light is flashing. We'll go ahead and press that little button and it basically resets it. So it does work really well. So we're going to go ahead and now move on to our next test, which this will be the last one. This is going to be our load test. And so right now you can see I have a meter set up to this thing with another camera so you guys can see the action live as it happens. We're going to go inside my test facility here real quick. And basically this is a 30 amp service travel trailer. And so you can see I'm burning about 200 watts right now. Well, that's because the converter is on. Now you watch the meter, it goes down to zero, so I don't need the converter on to charge the battery. I can do that with solar that I have. So now that we have all full power of the generator and the trailer is not using any power, we're going to go ahead and turn on basically the AC fan, or basically the fan only. So now you see the meter come up and you see a few watts being burned, and we're burning about, well, maybe 2.25 amps. And that is a 15K AC unit, which I've heard this generator will actually fire it up. So we're going to go ahead and try it. See how well it does. And boom, look at that, fired it up pretty much no problem. You hear the generator kind of rev up a little bit, but that's about it. I mean, look how well that did. It's blowing cold air already. And again, this is a 15 amp generator, and if you look at our power that we're drawing out of the trailer, we're pretty much maxed out as far as power goes on our amps, and our watts is supposed to be 1800 peak. So while this thing is actually running at peak, we'll actually see what the sound levels are as well. And I do this sound check back here with pretty much every generator I test, and these are basically the same numbers that I see from other small generators and even the big ones as well. So I hope you guys liked the video. Definitely smash that like button and subscribe.